from the
studio
of the
iconic
Governor's Comedy
Club.
This is Circling the Drain.
It's a nice day to start again.
Oh my God, can we start again? I don't think you want us to. We are the Circling the Drain podcast. And I think we should all get a medal for what we've been through in the past hour.
Yeah.
The past day.
Past day. You want to do over for the entire day.
Yes, I do. I do. Today sucked.
It wasn't the greatest day. I also got into like a large-ass traffic jam on the way here. I hate getting into those. It's not what Carolina went through. So okay. It's white people problems, hashtag. But not the greatest of days, so I'm glad we're all here and actually yes. doing some podcasting.
Well, we're not all here, but we'll get to that.
All in three is the word, really?
It's a key three thing. It's okay, ladies and gentlemen. That didn't work. I am Ira, and usually at this point I get to make a little quip, and I get to say, there's my buddy Sean! Wait, he's not here. So I have a unique opportunity. Something I've never gotten to do. Mm-hmm. I get to introduce the royalty side of the table.
Oh, yeah.
I get to introduce, ladies and gentlemen, the first lady of our podcast, the queen of heels, Lady Flip Flops. She may have had a bad day, but she's gonna be here to make you laugh. Carolina!
I love it. Pretty bad day. Listen, I'm going to really try to put my bad mood, bad vibes aside, and I'm going to try to give y'all a great show today.
Aw, that's what we appreciate about you. See, so it's better than walking in and going, off with their head, which you did.
Off with their heads!
And my head is still here. What the hell? Thank you for the pardon, Lady Queen.
Lady Flip Flop.
Listen, if there's no Lord Radford around here, I don't know who my royalty is.
He can't interrupt Sean, so he doesn't know when to talk.
That is true.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his triumphant return. It's Pickles!
And I am acknowledging the restraining order that Sean gave me to stay at least 25 miles away from him, so hopefully...
And do me a favor, soon. Do me a favor, please, stand up so you can show the camera your shirt.
Yep.
It's all kinds of pickles.
Yeah.
He gets the joke. Yep. There we go.
I know the assignment. Got this off of Amazon. I don't remember who the artist is. I have to give him a shout out once I look at my order history. So.
Are these like real jars of pickles?
The real brands of pickles.
I know Vlasic.
You got Mount Olive. I know Mount Olive. Deeds and Watson. This is the Whole Foods brand.
Yeah,
and I think some of them I know.
Clausen.
I think they're all brands somewhere.
Oh, that's cool.
So you didn't come for the pickles, you came for the comedy, right?
I did.
We don't have a shirt with that. No. We should do a shirt with that. Maybe we should do a shirt with that.
I gotta find more shirts online.
Or maybe we could just do Shotgun Stories. Sean! Oh wait.
Oh, wow.
Okay, Pickles, you want to give it a shot?
All right, so drink whenever you can in a few minutes. What we do is...
Oh, sorry.
That's not drinking. We go around the world to... What we do is we go around the world and we talk about anything that is weird to us. It could be in the United States. It could be all around the world. It could even be in Florida. But what we're going to do is Ira, Carolina, and myself are all going to read a story, and then you will get to vote on the Circling the Drain Facebook page of which story you like the best. Vote for whoever you like. Vote for Sean, even though he's not here if you want. You have mm-hmm. that right. It is America. Shotgun Stories.
There we go. Now, oh God. Carolina!
Yeah.
Two wins in a row, Carolina.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
So last week, you did a good story.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah. Wait. And you already have two punishments. And she loves punishments. And, damn it, I really do hate hitting the... What happened to my buttons here? Hold on. Hold on, something did happen to my buttons. Because all of the... Oh, all okay, right. It's back. And so... Damn it. The winner is... Yeah!
Oh, hey! Oh.
It's all right. I still got you. Congratulations,
you had
Ira.
To. Thank you. It's hard to beat a story about an emotional animal.
Oh,
an emotional support alligator.
Yeah, yes. That was kind of hard.
That was it.
By the way, yes. We all make sure we tell everybody where our stories are coming from. Mm-hmm. And Caroline on her text message, Shay doesn't say where the stories come from. It's like, I know what I want to do for my two punishments. I'm like,
yeah.
There
yeah,
is somebody
yeah,
who just loves to torture the hell out of us.
Listen.
And she is Lady Flip Flop.
Mm-hmm.
I see some really good videos that Fernando doesn't let me try on him. So,
oh, God.
I gotta try it on y'all.
Fernando, one of these days, you better let her try one thing.
Why? That'll be the most painful. And what's funny is she goes, I can't do it in the studio. So I'm going to take you outside to torture you.
Yeah, no, I can't do it in here.
Oh, I God. Don't know I what the laws are of this. So I'm going to read up on the law and then I'll get back to you.
We're
going to
check law of the land.
Well,
safety.
To be fair,
mm-hmm.
I am not the one punishing you guys. You guys punish each other. I just come up with the idea.
It's everyone who's listening.
So
they're the ones who pick. They're the ones
No,
who...
I'm saying, no. Whenever it involved pain, I make y'all fuck each other over. I don't get involved with
Drink.
That.
Drink.
You guys can screw each other
Okay,
over.
Well, I'm going to start with my story. And I took, since animals worked for me before,
okay.
I figured this is a good story. It's just entitled Drunk Monkey on the Loose.
Oh, okay.
So we're going to Indiana. We're a monkey named Momo.
Oh,
it's Momo. Who is it? Exactly? It's Momo. Come here, Momo. Momo.
Okay. Is it a baby?
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
A monkey named Momo is on the loose in Indianapolis. One neighbor reported seeing the simian in the garbage can sipping beers.
Oh, man. The first step of having a problem is admitting you have a problem. And that monkey just said, Momo, 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 Momo.
No, that's just it. Is that Mo? You got Mo? Momo, Momo. He learned one word, Mo. Indianapolis police says Momo escaped from his owner's home and was subsequently spotted in the neighborhood about a quarter mile away by the bodega, man. Come on, hey. Police say that they weren't drink, by the way. Police say they were unable to confirm whether Momo had bitten anyone while on the loose. At least one neighbor reported to the police Momo was seen drinking beers out of a garbage can. Indianapolis code allows for the ownership of a wild or dangerous animal. By the way, first thing, if I have a pet and they go, you know, that's a wild and dangerous animal, maybe that's not my pet. See the emotional support alligator from last week.
Yeah. I feel like the emotional support alligator was probably safer.
Then Momo the drunk monkey?
Yeah, well, I mean, he's not an alcoholic. You don't know what happens when he gets emotional immediately. It's like, oh,
he can get aggressive.
I'm thinking, yeah.
He can get a little aggressive.
I'm like, okay, if they're both angry and coming at you, which one do you have a better chance of getting away from?
The alligator. Too slow.
The alligator?
The alligator.
Well, unless you're in water.
He's in the bath. Are you taking a bath with him?
You might.
What are you going to name?
What else are you going to put him in?
Oh, what was it? A Wally Gator. Yes, his name is Wally Gator. Come on, little Wally Gator. Little shampoo on Wally Gator. No! Not doing that.
Conditioner.
Death roll. Yeah, well, in one.
And then he has to moisturize.
But you could have a wild or dangerous animal, but it requires them to be registered with Animal Care Services. There has been an update since this story broke. Momo the monkey has been captured by authorities.
Aww.
He broke into a home. Neighbor spotted him, called 911. The police quickly trapped him inside. They shut all the doors. And then the monkey went right into the bathroom where the authorities were able to apprehend him. How rude is that?
He was just performing his monkey business.
Oh. I'm thinking the monkey's going, you don't buy beer, you rent it. Let me go to the bathroom, and then we're fine.
So,
no.
he broke the seal.
He did.
I hate.
There's another animal. Wait a minute.
He broke the seal while breaking the seal.
I think the monkey has a problem when he starts asking for I don't know, what's the cheapest beer?
I want some Pabst Blue Ribbon PBR for life.
I was outside with a cup, and this guy put a dime in it. Can I have a Pabst Blue Ribbon, please? Anybody? No.
You want some? I want need some Cuervo. I need some Cuervo.
I just want a lime. Is that Momo lime?
Is he saying his name? No, he's just saying once more.
Okay, who wants to follow that up?
I will take it. So
wait, hold on. Now pinch hitting for Sean. Color green pickles.
Number two. Unfortunately, I cannot add an animal story in Sean's honor. So let's see how this works. We're going to Alaska, where an Alaskan bank robber who was caught immediately after his heist while counting his loot outside of the targeted branch was nabbed again trying to rob the same bank that he robbed 5 years earlier.
What
his name
dumbass.
Is Michael Gale Nash. Swiftly
Michael, is that you again?
Hi, Michael. So he was swiftly taken into custody for carrying out the same failed scheme that closely resembled the fumble that he had 5 years earlier. The botched 2018 burglary earned him a spot on a couple of dumbest criminals list after he slipped a teller a demand note with his name and birth date scrawled on the back.
Ugh.
Because, of course, you need an ID to basically say, if you're going to steal, you have to be at least 17 or older. Clad in black jeans, black boots, black everything, Nash allegedly sauntered up to a First National Bank in Anchorage at 9 a.m. and began violently pulling on the doors, according to the office of the Alaska U.S. Attorney. Now, employees told her that the bank would not open for another hour, so he stood his ground and passed a note through the locked doors to a bank supervisor. This is a robbery. Put the money in the bag, and I will walk out. This is a robbery. God,
hi, it's me, Michael. Can you let me in? No? Okay, here's a
note. I tried this before. Come on.
If you would just let me in to rob you, just open the door.
I will leave as soon as I'm done. I promise.
Luckily for him, he did not include his personal notification or information on the note this time around, so at least he improved it. Right. Supervisor immediately yelled for the bank door to be locked via a secondary locking mechanism and called 911, but Nash continued loitering in front of the bank. Nervous and stuttering, he allegedly rejected the bank security officer's pleas for the robber to leave and instead encouraged him to call the police. This is not good when someone does this the second time, and then he peacefully submitted when the police came and was transferred to the police department precinct.
Okay, well,
yeah, a lot of stupid in here.
I don't know what to say.
Stupid is and stupid does, apparently. Okay, hand me the money. Oh, well, Michael, would you like me to empty your account? No, not mine. Well, yeah. Could I have 20 out of my account? And everybody else's money. Michael, 5 years ago, we tried this. Didn't we talk to you about this?
Nash, by the way, has a lot of other convictions on his rap sheet. Stealing personal property in 1993, forgery in 2000, and distributed drugs in 1996. So let's just say it's more than weed in this case. I think it were more the cocaine is a hell of a drug line.
He wasn't there for intoxication. I mean, no drugs in his system? You said selling.
Yeah, it was selling, but it was just like,
this guy's got to be doing something.
I'm pretty sure he's on something.
Again, he only got sentenced to apparently a year the first time he did it. So it's like, you know what they say? If at first you don't succeed, try again.
I think
kids, you can learn from this.
I think he's hooked on phonics. One, count that. You're under arrest. I only got to five. Excuse
now
me.
Now we're going
to
settle over.
Okay. Carolina, you're up.
So, my story takes place in Durango, Colorado. So, let's see. It happened outside of a store. Well, some lady got arrested outside of a mattress outlet on September 27th. She was arrested for attacking their 6-foot-tall mattress named Maddie.
6-foot-tall?
Most women would date that mattress.
I know.
Maddie.
Okay, Maddie. Maddie the mattress.
Maddie the mascot mattress.
Maddie the mascot. Okay,
right,
it.
Right.
I hated those tongue twisters. Maddie the mascot mattress. Yeah. Maddie the mascot mattress. Maddie the mascot. Okay.
So
you're under arrest, Michael.
The employee playing him was only a few minutes into his shift when the woman showed up and started hugging him. She quickly became aggressive. The manager described her as drunk out of her mind. He says he kept trying to shove and trip Maddie to get him on the ground.
She must have been hanging out. She must have been hanging out with that monkey, by the way.
Momo? Yeah. Momo the mattress mascot?
Oh, God.
Do you, Momo, take Maddie the mascot mattress? Never mind.
So eventually she did knock him on the ground. Then she stood over him and started screaming profanities. Maddie eventually got up, ran inside, and held the door closed while they called 911.
It's my store now, mattress! My store!
I wonder how many mattresses would call 911 on their owners when they come home drunk. That's right, I'm gonna lay all up. 911.
Do you know how hard it is to clean up vomit from those sheets?
Oh.
I don't, but okay.
So, while they were calling the cops, she kept banging on the door through a sign that they had set up outside. Cops eventually caught up with her and did arrest her for assault.
So she didn't buy a mattress, is what you're saying?
No, she never even made it inside the store.
Aw.
And she left off the last S of the arrest for savings.
She used the last S for assault. Come on in, assault Maddie the mattress. Never mind.
Leave off the last S for assault.
Why do they all start with a drunk woman?
Because
it's
the best
perfect
stories.
Way to start the story. A drunk woman, you know it's going to win.
Or
so,
Florida.
Congratulations.
Do you have any stories that you tell your friends that start off with, so I was drunk?
No.
Damn. Okay.
No.
There goes that segment. So this week you can either vote for Momo, Maddie, or Michael. And M is going to win somehow. You put up the poll, which is going to be up on the drain. You can go there all week. You can vote as many times as you want. You can vote for one story, as many stories as you'd like. Just vote, vote, vote. Go to the drain. Thank you. And now we move on with the show.
Already in progress. Oh, wait, that's later.
No, that's later.
I'm Rusty!
Okay, Rusty. We got a new nickname.
Michael Rusty Pickles.
Do we know what Friday is? What Friday's date is?
Mm-hmm. Friday the 13th.
Mm-hmm. You are both correct. Mm-hmm. In 2 days, it's going to be Friday the 13th, the date that people generally consider bad luck. I think Carolina would consider today, but hey.
Oh, hell yeah. Today was fucking horrible. Let's not.
Drink. Which is what she wants to do.
I do, actually.
But do you know why Friday the 13th is considered?
Yes, I do know why. I don't know if it...
There goes the story. No, go ahead.
Oh,
go ahead.
Okay. I don't know if it's what...
Go.
But I know it has to do with, like, the Knights Templar. They were hunted by the church or some shit like that and killed.
Drink.
And it was on a Friday the 13th, which is in October, so that's why it's bad luck.
That's one.
Yeah, okay.
There's also, let's see, here we go. It's about superstitions. I'm going to tell you what a few of them are. The number 13 makes people nervous because where is it? Say what happens when it's too small and it's not your fault.
Sorry.
That was page 13. That got lost, actually.
Although many Americans believe follow superstitions, where is 13th? Here we go. The biblical...
Drink!
Wrong person.
The biblical Last Supper. Because there were 13 people at supper, and the next day Jesus was arrested and crucified. It became unlucky to sit at a table for 13 people. This turned more widespread negative when the number 13... today, even tons of buildings don't even have a 13th floor for fear of bad luck.
Yep.
But the 14th floor is just now the 13th floor. Additional, the crucifixion took place on Friday. Therefore, the combination was Friday the 13th, and it's considered unlucky. There's also something in Roman times where Loki showed up, and he was the 13th, and he did something bad. There's like a whole bunch of stuff, including the one that you said.
Loki is real.
Maybe. No. No. Well, I mean, I don't know. I have Disney Plus. He's on there. Go check out Loki.
Hi, Tom Hiddleston.
What does that have to do with Roman times?
It doesn't.
Oh.
A study of 1,000 Americans. Don't worry about it. A study of 1,000 Americans found 13% of Americans consider themselves superstitious.
really 13% of themselves consider them circumcisious.
The rest of them were just average-cicious. Yes. Yeah. But in the same study, 35% of the people say they would consider picking up a good penny for good luck. You know, face up.
Mm.
All right. You guys have any superstitions that you believe in?
That I believe in?
Yeah. Would you walk under a ladder?
I mean, I try to avoid them, but...
That's what I always think. I'm like, why would I walk under a ladder when I can walk around it?
I just try to avoid it, but I mean, I wouldn't have a problem walking under it.
I used to, and I don't know why I did this, I used to, like, when I was going to, like, work in the city, I used to, like, when I was going up an escalator, I used to just, like, starting to, like, skip steps. For some reason,
Did you believe something was happening?
I thought I would have a bad day if I skipped steps. And it didn't really matter in the end, but I was just like, make sure you don't step on that second to last step. So
he was trying to escalate his day.
I was trying.
No, don't drink.
I'm trying not to climb the ladder of success.
You've succeeded.
Apparently.
I feel like there is one. I just can't think about it.
I had a black cat. I love that thing to death. I don't fear them.
No.
Do you throw salt over your shoulder?
No.
Do you do that?
No. I feel like that's not like an evil spirits taking away type thing.
I don't know what it's for.
Well, here we go. Spilling salt is bad luck because it was linked to a biblical event in Leonardo da Vinci's The Last Supper. Again, going back to that. Judas spilled over the salt, and Judas was the one who betrayed Jesus. By the way, if you're tuning in for any religious whatsoever, I don't know why you're here, but people believe that.
Thank you for coming, though, and and pray after the show after you enjoy our drinking game. Just do it.
So the spilled salt is what invited the devil to whisper in Judas's ear. So if you take the spilled salt and you throw it over your shoulder, it's supposed to blind the devil.
Ow! Oh, my God! Wait. Wouldn't the fire also blind the devil?
You're supposed to blind the devil?
Yeah, so the devil is whispering in your ear. You spill salt, you just go, oh, boom, and throw it in his eye.
When you spill the salt, you're supposed to take it and
throw it over your shoulder.
Oh.
What if it's that? What if it's windy?
I've never heard of that.
What if it's windy, it wouldn't hit the devil? I mean, does it hit the devil every single time? No one has that accurate of aim.
I think he would just show up with, like, popcorn. Like, oh, thank you. And you know what? The spaghetti's a little bit... Thank you. A little French Red Hot, baby. Throw that over your shoulder.
I put that shit on everything.
There you go. Other superstitions are less religious, so hooray. Anybody afraid of breaking a mirror? I mean, nobody likes to break anything because it's glass.
I've actually broken a mirror.
I've broken one
mirror. Anything happened to you?
I mean, it was over 7 years ago, so if it happened, I think the bad luck wore off.
It was actually 7 years ago today. Who knew?
And obviously it didn't work.
No!
Oh, Fernando broke a mirror recently.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, he's
and are you going to go home and beat the hell out of him?
I might.
Okay, there
maybe
you go. It's bad luck.
Maybe you should
try one of the punishments on him and make it easier
he didn't
for
let
everybody.
Me, I said that's why I have to.
But
try
do
it on
you want
you
the
guys.
Punishment? That's what a punishment is.
She has to trek to the other side of the bed to try to find.
Too far.
Too lazy. That's true. Good point.
For example, the idea of breaking a mirror, bringing you 7 years of bad luck. Why? Because one's reflection was a representative of your soul, and it takes 7 years for the soul to fully recover. So if I break a freaking piece of glass, my soul No.
Man, if I had
ridiculous.
If it was all of like my phone screens that broke, my soul.
Oh my god!
Does that count?
No,
I hope not. No, that's not glass.
My soul would be dead.
It's tempered, isn't it? Tempered glass.
Tempered glass. Right,
okay, we're all screwed. That's why the world is screwed up because we all break our pickles has solved it. That's it.
Ding ding ding.
There you go.
Let's see. Why don't you open an umbrella indoors?
That I don't
I don't know.
Because it's not raining. Hey! No. it's linked to ancient Egyptian times when they would use papyrus umbrellas to shade nobility from the sun. So you're rich, so you. I don't want the sun on me. Someone would hold the umbrella over you. But the umbrellas were made to mimic the goddess of the sky. And shade from an umbrella was considered sacred. Therefore, no non-person who used an umbrella was offending the spirits. I don't.
Lady Flip-Flop, do you have any comment on that?
Yeah, that's stupid, but I'm not Lady Flip-Flop.
So from what I understand, peasants can't have shadow.
Sure, why not? Let's go with that. I'm here.
Yep, you know what?
That's there fair. We go. And knowing is half
and
the
if,
battle.
And if the peasants were not breaking their phones, we would not be in the situation that we are right now.
Off with their heads.
That's right. Wait.
By the way, nobody drinks because I didn't do it. But I did do this. There we go. Do you guys believe in aliens?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Not as much as she does, apparently, but...
Yeah, I believe in aliens.
You know what? I mean, like I say with most of these supernatural things, I know that I don't know. It could be. Might be. But I don't know. Here's the one thing I always say about aliens. So many people have thought to seen this, that, and the other thing. Mm-hmm. Everyone in the world is carrying their broken glass phone, which is why we're having such bad luck. Yeah. And nobody's taking pictures?
Okay. Listen.
Go.
Can
a sister get a minute?
Let me tell you. When I went to Utah with Fernando, I'm not going to get into what I saw.
Uh-oh.
We saw some shit. And I don't tell people because you're not going to believe me.
Go.
I don't want to get into it. I don't want to get into it.
Why didn't you take a picture of whatever you saw?
Okay, I'm about to get into that.
Okay.
So, we saw some shit, right? And
drink.
And we're like, what the, what is going on?
I like how she censors herself on what the, yep. Immediately following.
I don't want you to guys, to end to up get with alcohol poisoning just off of this story.
Okay.
So, Fernando was driving. That's when we rented the RV, right? We were in Utah. So, Fernando's driving. We both see it in the sky. We're both freaking out. So mm-hmm. Fernando's like, take a video.
Okay.
And I'm like, okay, hold on. Wait, I got to lower the window. Wait, let me lower the window. I gotta clean the lens so I get a good. And then I'm like, okay, babe. Okay,
please check this out on YouTube. Please.
And then I'm like, I got the pictures, babe. I got the pictures. Look here. I got the pictures. And he looked at me and he's like, I told you to get a video.
Mm-hmm.
You can't tell off of the picture. And then I'm like, fuck.
Drink.
And then I go long back drink. To the sky to try to take the video. And of course, it's gone.
Oh, I want the X-Files music right now so badly.
So I feel like when you're in that moment and you're quickly trying to, you're just so like, I don't know. Everything's going so quick. And I'm just like, okay, I got the video. But that isn't what we needed. I got the pictures, but we needed a video. And I didn't think in that moment. And that's what happened. And that's why I have no proof of what the fuck we saw. And that's why I don't want to talk about it.
What did you see? What did you see?
I'll tell you after the show.
Ooh, okay. Good for me. Although, well, Ring Doorbell is offering $1 million if you get a shot of an alien. However, it has to be on their Ring doorbell. So, trick or treat. Oh, hold on a minute. If you know they're out there, the video doorbell maker Ring is willing to pay you for proof. They're offering customers a chance to win $1 million if they use their doorbell camera to capture a video of an alien encounter. According to the company, $1 million grand prize will go to the person who captures unaltered scientific evidence of a real extraterrestrial life form on their or outdoor Ring device, the indoor or outdoor. Whether it's a video of an ET walking or whatever they're doing up your driveway and asking for directions, or an unidentifiable life form exhibiting unusual and extraordinary behavior in your backyard, submit your best footage.
Excuse me, can you find my way to the gas station? I don't know where I'm going right now. I took a left over in Albuquerque, and now I'm over here. I don't know where I'm going. Just go.
Okay, question.
Okay, that 30 seconds is erased. So
question.
I'm erasing it from my mind, that's for sure.
So they actually want a picture of a body. It can't be of, like, a UFO.
Well, it will be a video.
Oh, yeah. There was a video.
So you won't have to worry. Carolina, did you take a damn video?
Why is it a panorama? I said video.
I was under pressure. It's too much pressure. But okay, so they want an actual video of a body, not of something, of a, yes, a flying UFO.
Correct.
Okay, got
it. So if you can get an alien trick-or-treating at your house this year and capture it on Ring, send it in and go, I you didn't say it was real. I really don't know what the Johnson kid is dressed up as. That's an extraterrestrial to me. So
no? He's deformed, all right? Leave him alone.
Oh,
he's
not an actual alien!
Do you have some relatives that can pass as illegal aliens? Maybe we can get them in.
I mean, I'm a little sure. I'm sure. All I got to do is punch down a little bit. You can paint me green.
There we go. Come on. We could do that.
I'll try to play it off.
And we're going to go from aliens to the Amish.
Ooh. Same thing.
I was gonna be like, that's close enough. That's close enough.
I think we could take pictures of that.
Both of them haven't used electricity ever, so.
Amish busted is pretty much should be the headline. Eli Yoder.
That's the most Amish name that you could possibly ever come up with. That's like the Amish name generator, just spitting out Eli Yoder.
Okay, give me another one. If that's number one, then what's number two?
Hezekiah Johnson.
Johnson?
I don't know. I couldn't think of a good last name, but Eli Yoder's perfect.
Hezekiah is not bad. Eli Yoder, he is an ex-Amish person. Over the last few years, he's been supplying a few of the Amish men in the order that he was in with cell phones.
Why just the men, huh?
Because they're the ones asking.
And the women.
It's illegal. It's still illegal.
No, I know. But
okay.
You ain't give to no women?
Well, the women ain't coming out going, psst, I need a cell phone.
So they're probably doing the cheat.
Possibly.
That's what it is. Mm-hmm.
Eli, I know I can't wear pink, but can I have a cell phone? whenever they request somebody, he will do everything in his power to try to sneak them a cell phone. The Amish are forbidden, as we know, from using, if anything, of modern technology. So, as we all know now, on October 4th, every cell phone in the United States buzzed with a nationwide emergency alert test, and the buzzing awkwardly outed all his friends who were carrying their phones with them. I got a couple of my Amish buddies shunned today by the Amish church, Yoder said. He himself may have to be shunned, said the Amish church, which is a term for excluding them, isolation. So nobody can even talk to him. In which case, ever. He's like he never existed.
So he's no longer an Amish person?
Once he did Rumspringa, which was, Rumspringer is you get a week to do whatever you want.
Oh, yeah.
And then you can decide.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And that was it. So he decided, I'm not going to be Amish, but I can talk to them. Now, no, you're bad. Oh. You're gone. You brought the devil in the phone. And by the way, Hezekiah cracked his case. And now 7 years of bad luck on the order. Thank you for the Hezekiah.
That sucks, man. Poor them. That sucks for the
Amish. Poor them.
Amish.
Hold on. Okay, left side of the barn for the barn raising. Beep, beep, beep. What the?
Is it the extraterrestrials?
Get the Ring doorbell!
Ring doorbell immediately.
I actually was reading some stories about that, and I saw a guy, I read a story of a guy who said that he was already in the process of, like, being shunned. Like, he was...
Okay.
I think they were having a meeting whether or not he should be shunned or not. And then that whole thing with the phone happened. And then he's like, oh, I'm definitely going to be shunned now. Like, I'm definitely shunned.
I'm shunning you. It's an emergency.
There was a show called Breaking Amish.
Oh, yes.
And it was so good just seeing how these people are, like, shocked at what real life actually
is. You've never looked at my car, have you?
No.
There is a special sticker on there. It says protected by Lebanon Levi, who was like the Amish mafia on the show.
Yep.
Yeah, they had Amish mafia on the show.
Wait.
I saw that one, by the way. Oh, there's many.
I don't know if I can answer them.
I'm going to write this down. Amish mafia. We'll get back to this.
Yeah, what was the name of the show?
Breaking Amish.
Look that up. You can binge that. It's a hell of a show. I'm sure none of it's real. I hope none of it's real.
I wish. I hope.
I don't want to watch it.
I think you should watch it just to make sure. You know what else you should do? You should order from Cake Chick.
Yes, you should.
Halloween's coming up. Don't you want a cupcake that bleeds?
I do.
Of course.
I got candles. I want a matching cupcake that bleeds.
Oh, my God. That would be... I love... She has a design that I'll put up eventually of little hatchets and little guns. And you, they're like sprinkles. You can eat them. They're awesome. And that's what's about Cake Chick. You get what you want. She's going to exceed your expectations. You walk up and just go, I don't know, give me some chocolate cupcakes and some chocolate frosting and write happy birthday. That's boring.
That's so boring.
Go on her site. You go to Instagram. You put in Cake Chick 1217 or go to Facebook, Cake Chick, and you're going to see the amazing designs. And challenge her. Tell her what you want, and she's going to add on to it. You know what? I want one that looks like my husband murdered by the Amish and his cell phone going on. And she'll go, okay, do you want it bleeding or do you want the hatchet, you know, the wound out of the neck? I don't know why it turned so bad, apparently, on this commercial.
This got dark, by the way, really quick.
Whatever you want, she's going to do. It's going to look like that. It's going to taste amazing because everything she does tastes amazing. So now we've got, let's say it looks good. It tastes good. It's going to cost a lot of money. No! And we're going to help you with that by giving you a promo code of three letters.
C-T-D. Yes, C-T-D.
I really thought he was going to spell cat, but okay. And how much do you get off?
You'll get 20% off.
Oh, my God. So how could you not go there? It's going to exceed your expectations. Order now, but give her at least a week's notice.
I do want to say... Every time I've wanted something from Cake Chick a specific way, she's always come through.
That's
even
right.
With this last request, I'm like, can she do this, Sarah? And
damn,
I didn't think she
fly.
Was going to be
Sorry.
Able to. And yes, she can do it. So,
That's right. She could do anything. And how did it taste?
Amazing. As always.
That's it. You're going to have people coming at you going, where'd you get this? Entenmann's? No! I ordered from Cake Chick and you can too. Now back to the show.
Already in progress.
And done. Guys, we have done stories now of trucks overturning and everything spilling out.
Yes.
We have had cheese. We've had salsa.
We've had Alfredo sauce.
It's funny, actually. Yes. My friend texted me. Well, actually, my coworker. She went out on a Starbucks run, and then she's like, "Guys, I'm gonna be a little late." And she texted a picture. She's like, "A truck just spilled all of this," and I'm like, "Oh shit! It actually does happen, like in real life."
Was it Starbucks? She can go out and just keep filling up.
Get me the venti coffee.
I have the mother load.
Oh, boy.
I don't think we're ever going to do another story of an overturned truck because nothing will beat this.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
It took place in Russia.
Oh, it's vodka.
And I wish. by the way, there's one of wine that flooded the streets. They had bees. We had one a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, yes, with bees.
Bees came out. But this one is, again, a truck driver in Russia lost his load after an accident.
Okay. Oh, no.
There was apparently no significant material damage. No one called the police. After exchanging details, the driver of the truck and the car apparently left and went on their way. However, he had lost his load as hundreds of white plaster casts of vaginas.
Oh, ding, ding. We're done. That's it. Story. Yep. We've passed. We've done.
Now they were believed to be taken to an art gallery, but right now they tumbled all over the road.
Oh man!
A video footage from news showed a trail of broken vaginas leading
Christ.
To the back of a truck. There was a crack,
Jesus Christ, another crack, and another crack.
All in the same place, ironically enough.
Now, if you're thinking what I was thinking when I started reading this, okay, so it was a sex toy thing?
Firework.
No.
Uh-oh.
Firework, yes. No. Go ahead.
No, I'm just confused.
Okay, so all the vaginas are on the floor?
Yeah, and broken.
There are some broken vaginas. Uh-huh. Gynecologists were called. The vaginas were to be used on a 26-foot wall installation at an art gallery called The Great Wall of Vaginas.
Oh, we can't do any puns anymore on this show either. The Great Wall of Vaginas, officially, we're done. We're done.
By the way, and you're thinking, well, okay, he took one and he just manufactured it over.
No, this was like hundreds of different
400 different women donated their genitals.
Oh, my God.
Well, they didn't donate them, but their likeness in plaster to art. I salute you, sir.
I probably would have donated mine.
You're going to donate yours?
I probably would have.
Get this woman to Russia.
No. Wait.
There's no money in that for you.
Okay, yeah, no, I'm not.
By the way,
join our OnlyFans. It doesn't exist.
Another sexist story. You're talking earlier about the women not being offered phones.
Mm-hmm.
Where are the men in this installation? Why can't we have...
So Pickles wants the 26-foot wall of
phallus. I don't want it, but I'm just saying.
I think you want it.
I don't.
I think he wants it.
No one wants to see that.
See? Nobody wants to see that.
I don't know how they're going to make the art installation. Anything that would be...
Hey, baby, they can do this.
Hey, this is the 17th time you've gone over here into this art installation.
Well, I haven't installed it yet. Hold on. I have to test each and every... Hold on. 1,389! 1,390! Ooh, hold on. That was a little... He really did lose his load on that one, didn't he?
1,390! Oh! 1,391 again!
Okay, well, let me turn that off. It's spooky month!
Yeah.
Spooky month!
Yes.
Just in time for Halloween, sink your fangs into Stephen King's Scream job. Is that what you do with a plastic?
I was going to say, that's exactly
that?
The person.
For the third time, usdish.com is looking for one lucky or unlucky fan to watch 13 Stephen King movies in a row. In a row. So there's a day. There's a Saturday gone.
That's a weekend, not a day.
Yeah.
13, pretty much an hour and a half for each movie.
I don't know if it's an hour and a half. I'm sure.
Stephen King, I feel like his movies are long. Oh. Wasn't it like a freaking 6-hour movie?
Yeah,
like
three hour? That was the movie. Well, no, that's right. They did do the movie. Eh.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. It's a weekend. And I didn't write this. The Cellbubration. Okay. We want to pay whoever does this $1,300 to witness the horror classics. As you watch,
terrible.
We will ask you to note how everything's going. How's it going?
I feel like
watching a movie.
Fine. Leave me alone. I'm in the middle of this movie. Come back to me in an hour.
Does it say a list of the movies?
It does. I'll get to that in a minute.
Okay.
You'll note how everything's going, how your heart rate is during these scary scenes. So you have to sit there with a heart monitor and go, okay, here it comes. Hold on. Pause it for a sec. Okay, this is where he comes through with the knife. Okay, now. You just ruined everything.
What if you don't know the scary parts are coming? What if I've never seen the movie?
Well, in that case, you know, I guess just hook up a heart monitor and leave it there. I don't know. I'm sure your Apple Watch can do that nowadays.
Carolina would just accidentally take the picture of her heart instead of actually doing the heart monitor portion of it. It's like, damn it, again?
I don't know. I'd rather see an art installation of 4,000 vaginas rather than do this. Let's see. Which movie is your favorite, least favorite? Are you watching these flicks alone, or are you bringing a friend along so you can have night terrors together? What kind of friends do you have? 1,300 earnings will give them... Oh, God.
Say it.
I apologize. The $1,300 earnings will surely give them pumpkin to talk about.
Oh, my God.
So I should just write
some of these things now with our bad dad jokes going on with these things. It's not even bad.
Sign up
now.
Show us you've got the guts to watch. Now, here are the 13. Carrie.
Okay.
Christine.
Okay.
Never seen that.
Christine is the car. It's a car that comes to life and corrupts a young boy.
Nope.
Creep Show.
Nope.
I wish Sean were here because he would be... He would explain all of them.
He would explain every single one of these to the T. It's like, I think Creepshow's like maybe third in there.
Cujo. Yeah. Okay. The dog.
Love that.
Dr. Sleep, which I
no,
that alerts me.
I've never seen that.
I've heard of it, but I haven't seen that.
Firestarter.
Yep.
Nope.
Young Drew Barrymore. It and It Too.
Ugh.
Misery.
Dr. Sleep, by the way, is the sequel to The Shining.
Ah, there you go. The Mist, which I have seen.
I've seen that
one. That freaked me out a little
me too.
Day. Pet Cemetery.
Wow.
Okay.
Salem's Lot and The Shining.
Salem's Lot?
Salem's Lot. And Google?
Is that after Pet Cemetery?
He's about to look it up. I'm not Stephen King aficionado. Mr. Radford is not here.
Salem's Lot.
Drink.
That's true. Salem's
Momo!
Momo! Stop drinking, Momo. Stop drinking those White Claws, Momo. Salem's Lot is a movie from 1979.
Okay.
About a writer who returns to his hometown of Jerusalem's Lot and discovers the presence of a vampire.
A dampire?
Vampire.
Nope, never seen that.
Dampire!
Dampire! How you doing?
Oh, man. Dampire, you looking so good, Drax.
See, the problem is the books, as usual, are better than the movies.
Oh, always. With King, yeah, always. Definitely.
So he even hates the movies that they make out of his books.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, 13? Okay, so 13 times 2, 26. It's going to take more than a day to do this.
Do you have to watch it back to back?
It doesn't necessarily say, but it does say a marathon, so.
Okay, I mean, that might help out a little bit. But 1,300 is a good chunk of change to basically just watch.
But how much sleep do you actually get if you watch like 7 of these and then go, okay, I'm going to take a nap and then I'm going to wake up in the morning and you're just wake up
I mean, I don't give a fuck what you say. I'm putting cartoons on when I'm going to sleep. I am going to sleep watching cartoons. I don't give a fuck what you say.
Yeah, because, you know, watching Tom and Jerry and trying to kill someone with an iron and axe bullets, that's
I mean,
comedy.
Like, you know, like the Rugrats, SpongeBob, Doug.
I missed the one where...
The Nanny.
Yeah. The Nanny is not...
it's not cartoon, but it makes me laugh.
She considers Jewish people cartoons.
No, stop
she
it.
Just sees offensive. Right here.
I did not say that. I was not the one that said that.
Rugrats.
That was IROC.
Rugrats, and The Nanny, Frasier.
Friends.
Yeah. Frasier. Yeah, friends. Oh, no, they weren't Jewish in that. Yeah. Damn fly. Still in here.
Flies.
Flies not... No, I had a joke and I forgot it, so it doesn't matter. So I'll just hit this button. Carolina.
See?
Did you know that it's Croctober?
No. Never even heard of that.
You know what Croctober is?
Like a crocodile?
Worse.
Like the Crocs as in the shoe?
Bingo.
Ew.
Oh, that's stupid.
That's even worse than crocodile.
I would have taken the crocodile.
Now, we showed you, I think it was 2 years ago, they came out with a high-heeled shoe.
Let me see if I can bring it back up.
A croc-high-heeled shoe.
Yeah, can you look it up?
You didn't mind that one so much.
No,
I didn't mind it.
I hated it.
I was going to say, because I don't remember if I liked it or not, but I am 2 years older,
and
my feet are starting to hurt. So maybe a little comfort, you know, isn't so bad.
This provided comfort to you?
Oh, hell no. That shit's fucking ugly. That shit's not even comfortable. Let me see that shit again.
You know what? You don't even have to drink. It'll make you drink.
I mean, I hope it's very cushiony because that... Oh, it is. I could see it through. But
still, it looks like shit.
That's ugly.
Well, for Croctober, Crocs is known for its love it or hate it clogs. Hate it.
Okay. Yeah.
And epic collaborations with companies like Taco Bell and KFC.
Great tastes that taste great together. KFC and Crocs.
You put your Crocs in the trash. Yes, I did. Okay, we're done. Now the brand is giving its customers something they've been asking for forever.
Oh, no. I don't think they have.
No, they just unveiled the Crocs Classic. Wait, hold on. Wait.
Get ready.
For bold Western-inspired Crocs Classic cowboy boots.
No.
Please look that up.
Why?
No. Oh, God.
For what?
Because people have been clamoring for it.
For cowboy boots.
Are they drunk monkeys that have been clamoring for it, possibly?
I don't know.
So Momo's been on Amazon?
Yes.
I can't see Momo, this.
Momo
Derek
Cox. What?
Where's the cowboy boots? I need to be taller. I can't reach the good beer. I need to reach the good beer.
I don't see this being, you know, being very popular anymore.
Actually, does it look like...
Does it look like a cowboy boot?
It does look like a cowboy boot, but it looks like kind of a cowboy boot that you would wear on Halloween that's not actually a cowboy boot. It looks like kind of like a kid's cowboy boot. It looks weird, right?
Yeah, it's weird.
Oh, my Lord. Ew.
Ew.
Okay.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, I think I would dress my kid up in that for Halloween and then throw that out.
You know, yes, if your son's going to be a cowboy for Halloween, yeah, get him those because, you know, he's going to be doing a lot of walking. He wants to be comfortable. I understand, but for no other reason would you ever wear those ugly ass shoes.
So, wait, if you're at the club, a guy's wearing that? That's a crock.
By the way.
I don't even think they'll let you in the club with those shoes on.
Did you know there's also a croc day?
October 23rd. It's in the story.
Oh, okay.
Otherwise, I would not have.
Ugh.
Okay. described as one of the most widely requested croc shoe designs in brand history. Yes, but what we haven't done a boot. So you're saying, by the way, if it were Canadians, it would be easier. You want to do a boot? What about
what about it? What are you talking about?
I mean, about it.
We've had some complaints about this. We're very sorry about all of the complaints.
Sorry about all the crooks. What about it?
No.
Let's see. They have a high shine croc embossed texture and bold Western inspired stitching. It's even decorated with metallic jizz bits.
What?
What are jizz bits?
I'm afraid to ask.
I don't want. I don't think we need to even go to Carolina.
Can we go back to the vagina wall?
Yes.
Yeah. Let's just move on.
And it has
that's part of the vagina wall, actually. The jizz bits, ironically enough.
The jizz bits. They sprinkle the jizz bits all over.
That's how they stick together.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna look.
So Crocs are made out of jizz bits.
Oh, God.
So once it hardens, that's how you get Crocs.
There you go.
Soylent Green is people.
Jizz bits is Crocs.
And they also have a spur charm that
sperm
spins.
Charm?
Spur.
Okay.
Spur.
Okay.
Get your mind out of the jizz bits. Jizz bits are metallic, by the way.
Oh.
Ew. What? Did it block it on your phone?
No.
Adults only?
No. It's those stupid little charms that you add to your crop.
The metallic jizz bits are I don't find any charm in a metallic
what
jizz bit.
What were you calling jizz bits? That just does not...
That's what it says.
Right. That sounds so
I
off.
Think it might be gibbets. I'm not sure. Is it actually spell... It's spelled
you're right. But my way is a lot funnier.
Oh, no. Your way is much better. I think the jizz bits is perfect, but...
Other notable features include ventilation holes and a Crocs logo with a cowboy hat. Aw, they're only sold online and in certain Crocs stores for a limited time. You can join, oh my God, the wait list.
No,
see, can I join a list to get away from them?
See, there's always like something new, especially in like footwear. There's always going to be people that are going to want to buy it. And there's always and it's always like a new shiny toy, especially for someone normal who loves shoes. Because you're normal.
Those are atrocious. I feel like if I was to ever wear those, I'm getting my title revoked as the Queen of Heels.
Well, like you said, didn't you just say no right now? Your feet are starting to hurt.
No, hell no. I will take the pain. Listen, my feet are numb. Really, honestly, I don't feel my feet half the time. I've been in heels since.
This is the woman who says she will never
teens.
Ever go into flip flops
no,
at
I won't.
The reception
but
of
she's
a wedding.
Lady at a wedding.
Yeah,
well,
so she
at a wedding.
You talked. We talked about this.
I would never do that.
You would
what,
never
you
change
your
dance. Reception?
Wait, to flip flops.
So many brides.
Wait, what about sneakers?
Oh, a bride.
Yeah,
a bride.
Okay.
Absolutely not. I might wear a smaller heel, okay? But no, I'm not wearing flip-flops.
I'm going to get her
absolutely
wedding Crocs. Put the jizz bit on that.
You know what? If they have those in white, I might wear those in whites.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, wow.
I'm sure they do.
You know, no one will see those at that point.
My oh, my God.
Long enough.
Oh, my God. Guys!
Yeah.
Yeah, I forgot what I was going to say.
Just
hey. Have you ever done something or attempted to do something and just you're doing well? You're doing whatever you're doing. You're doing it right. Get your head out of the gutter.
Oh, I was just thinking, like
she's life? Like, I always do that well.
No, like life.
And something sidetracks you. Do you ever do that all the time?
Yes.
Oh, that's it. That's work.
That's work?
That's work.
Well, what sidetracks you at work?
Everything. You can't get shit done at work.
Drink.
Which, no, it's people, the phones, the you clients.
Mean, you mean other parts of work?
Yeah, other parts at work that don't let you finish your work.
Anything,
yeah.
Anything other than work, because that's just called multitasking. You're at your job and you're doing this, but you're at home and you're doing your taxes. I'm just picking anything. You're doing your taxes, and then, I don't know, a movie comes on. You go, I'm going to watch that movie instead.
Yeah.
Anything.
I was a... Monday, I was attempting to put my clean clothes away, but I got caught up in watching wrestling, and I didn't get very far in putting my clothes away.
Like 2 feet from where they
were? Yeah, I was supposed to be folding and then putting in the drawer, but I just stopped. And
I have this thing. If I ever stop something, first of all, I swatched.
You have a wife, who yells at you and says, Steven, get it done.
No, I mean, obviously, I'll be alone at that point because when we're both home, we're a lot more busy.
Oh, okay. Hold on.
I get sidetracked. And then the jizz bits come out.
But then you can go back to what you were doing. No, then I need a nap, usually.
Yeah.
But usually, I have to get something done, like, all of the time, because not only will it sidetrack me, I ain't getting back to it. Ever. Not ever, but it'll take a while to get back to it. Like, if I have a project and then I'm like, all of a sudden stop it for even any length of time, I'm done. Why? Because I have no, like, interest to be like, okay, I can't get myself immediately back into this unless there's, like, a goal in mind to
Can you give us an example? I'm sorry.
I have one.
Okay.
And it was interesting. I am terrible with paperwork. Thank God most things are electronic now, so I can just take a picture and put it away. But when I was married, everything would go into the desk, papers everywhere, just one big stack. But the good thing is, if ever I needed something, it would take me an hour to go through it, but I knew it was there. And my wife was constantly, just organize them. Just put them away. Always nagging me about that one thing. That was her pet peeve. But every time I tried to put them, organize them, I go, you know, now I'm going to sit back. She would come by. Why don't we do this right now? Why don't we do this? You want to go shopping right now? Okay. Then I saw a pattern. Every time I would try to do that, she would come in and suggest that I stop. So finally, I just said, do you realize that you keep bugging me to do this? But every time I go to do this, you're doing it because if I do this, you won't have anything to nag at me. And she looked at me and she just goes, wow, I think you're right.
It's true.
Oh, wow.
And if you're doing it,
yeah,
she probably wants it done her way, but you doing it her way. And it's like, and now all of a sudden, this place would be like, okay, where did I put this? Where did you put this? It's like, I organized everything. It's like, it's not where it used to be. Why didn't you let me know?
Because you said I should do. That's why men, by the way, do you and Fernando split chores? And this is totally we're off the reservation now.
Yes. Yeah, there's some things that he does and other things that I do. Like,
of the things that he does,
uh-huh.
Do you criticize any of them? That's not the way I do it. Why do you do it that way? I need you to do it this way. Ah, she's smiling, folks. She is.
Oh, well, yes. Okay, but I honestly
But in
feel...
my defense, he's wrong.
Yeah. Listen. Okay, he has to throw out the garbage, right? Whatever, right?
So, we're wrong. That's it.
But hear me out. I honestly think I have a point. Okay. So hear me out, right? He throws out the garbage, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. There are some times when we'll have like a plastic bag and we'll just fill that up, right? And whatever, we'll
of course
throw that out. So there's been times where that plastic bag, he's thrown it out just open. He didn't close it.
Oh, yeah.
He just threw it out.
Can't do
and
that.
It could have food or
animals,
whatever.
Yeah, animals.
Raccoons, you know,
so
time.
I told him, I'm like, please don't just throw out open bags, or he's thrown out.
Okay,
like,
you're right. You
like
are
food. Absolutely. Like, thank you. But that is
the more you know.
The only thing that I have told him, it's not like you're throwing out the garbage wrong. I just said, can you?
No, you are throwing out the garbage
you are
wrong.
I meant, like, whatever. Whatever.
He opens up the window and just heaves it into the road.
Throw it over the fence.
So I told him, I'm like, you know, it's gonna get all dirty and nasty and get maggots, and I'm not fucking cleaning that.
Every woman I've, you know, where you're splitting chores with has always been, what are you doing? I'm cleaning. No, you're not cleaning right. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, then we don't do it. Eventually, the man just stopped. The only thing I have now is my daughter is now living with her mother because she's closer to school and all that. So she comes back, and she always helps me with the laundry. I said, the only thing you have to do, your clothes, and do the towels. Towels, pretty easy. And she folds the towels, and I look at her, and I go, you're doing that wrong. And I'm not saying she's doing it wrong because they're not folded the way I want them to be. We have a little piece of furniture in the bathroom that holds 8 towels.
Mm-hmm.
It's this big. Mm-hmm. If it gets by a foot, by, I don't know, 2 feet.
Is it a situation where if you do
it has
wrong?
To be, right, it has to be folded this way so you can fit them in.
Mm.
And when you do it, it's wrong. She goes, but Mom yells at me when I don't fold the towels like that. I'm like, I don't know what to tell you. You know the situation here. You lived here for 20 years and whatever. But anyway, getting back to this, there was a woman who had a choice to make. Boston resident Sarah Bohan. She was running in the Chicago Marathon.
Okay.
And she saw something at mile 21. If you don't know, a marathon is 26.2 miles. She's at mile 21.
And something that we will never run.
Yeah, I would not.
Something I will never do.
Shit, I ran 2 miles, almost passed out. Oh, my God.
Drink.
Walking that far right now would be bad. that means my car's dead. Wait, don't wish that. Okay, knock salt over. Yeah. She is a she runs a lot of marathons. I was going to say professional, but that's not true. So she was doing her personal best. So imagine, oh my God, I'm going to beat my best time. Mm-hmm. That's something. At mile 21, she spotted a white fluffy thing on the sidewalk.
Oh no.
Bitch, keep running.
It was probably about 1 pound. Its fur was all matted.
Oh. Bitch, keep running.
No. It had marks underneath its eyes from not being well kept.
Bitch, don't keep running.
It
bitch,
was
keep running.
Crying. She recalls, nobody else seemed to notice the little creature. Was I going to kill it? Damn it. Yeah, got a little one. Okay. Not the little furry thing. No.
No.
Oh, kill it.
I went back. I hit it with a croc. seemed to notice it was a little kitten. It was a tiny little white kitten.
I would have kept running.
What, you would have kept running?
I would have fucking kept running.
Your personal best, and you would have ignored
my
the cat.
My personal best, and I see a cat, I would have kept running.
So you say,
oh, if it was a doggy, okay, different story. Kept running, but with the cat.
Well, thank you, person that thinks cats are evil.
By the way, okay, wait, does this make a difference? You happen to be running for a pet welfare group called Paws.
Yeah, I so
noticed.
And nobody
noticed. Yeah, that's fucked. No, they noticed
and
they kept
noticed.
Running.
You kept. It.
They all kept running. They noticed, but they wasn't stopping.
Listen,
hold
we're
on,
running.
Let me check my time. No, hell no.
We're running for the animals. Wait, that's a dead rat. Nope, keep going. Get my personal best.
Somebody
mark where the cat. I'm sure it's still going to be
21,
there.
21.
It's gonna all right, got to go back 5 miles.
I'm tired. She scooped up the cat. She began running with the cat.
Personal best?
She then had a choice to make from that point. You know, she could give the cat to somebody, hold this for me. She could do. Nope. She was, while running, asking people, you want to adopt a cat? Want to adopt a cat? Want to adopt a cat? Which slowed her down significantly. So she finished the race, didn't get her personal best.
Okay.
Paws was happy. Aww. And at the end of the race, she found a spectator who wanted the cat.
Okay.
So she finished the race.
Carolina would have just thrown it down the drain at that point, probably.
Carolina would have spiked it.
I would have done shit because I would have never stopped.
I finished the race. Oh, that was wrong. Did somebody clean that up?
I got to keep running. Just clean it up.
I'm running for pussy here. I'm running for pussy.
No, that's in Russia.
Oh no, that's right.
that's running for
Momo.
Pussy.
Clean that up, Momo. If you weren't here for Momo, then we don't know. Let's see. Oh man, we're a little over an hour, but I just want to tell you about our TSA agents. Because they are doing the Lord's work.
Are they now?
They are, because I got two stories here.
Oh, no.
A woman was stopped by Customs and Border Patrol at the Minnesota St. Paul International Airport.
Oh, Minnesota St. Paul.
Mm-hmm. She was found with blank. I was going to say it.
Oh, was it cocaine?
Cocaine.
No, this was seized. The woman was coming from Kenya.
Oh, Kenya. Ooh, Kenya. Africa. What a great continent.
They don't have any mayonnaise over there, though. I couldn't make a casserole.
Kenya.
She declared the blank.
Oh.
But it still had to be inspected by an agricultural specialist.
Diamonds. I don't know.
No?
Plaster of vagina.
Not Russia, Kenya. Momo. The passenger stated she obtained the blank while on her trip and intended to make a necklace out of it.
Still going with plaster vagina.
Again, no. She told the customs officers she had previously used blank.
Oh my God.
To make jewelry at home.
Sperm.
No, but you're warm. So's the sperm. They made jizz bits out of it. Yes. She brought jizz bits into the country. The blank was taken and destroyed by steam sterilization.
Blood?
Eggs?
No, but you're, you know.
Testicles.
No. Nope. I like that one.
Ovaries. I don't know.
Underies. Underoos. There's a real danger with bringing this type of stuff into the U.S. Here, a veterinary services permit is required to bring this into the U.S. Veterinary. So it's obviously something to do with an animal.
Is it that
that's dangerous?
Is it that
that you can make necklaces out of?
From Kenya.
Oh,
Kenya.
Ivory. Tusks.
I like the way you're thinking, but no.
From Kenya. What is poisonous in Kenya?
It's not poison.
Okay. Not poisonous. Just can't bring it into the United States.
At one point, I'm sure Crocs will make jizz bits out of it.
Dan, can you give us a hint? An animal.
It comes out
bones?
Of bones. It's all animals. So yes, bones is bones are all animals have bones.
Okay, a skeleton.
No nope.
Poop.
A whole butt.
Bingo. Now let's read the story. A woman was stopped by Customs and Border Patrol in Minnesota, St. Paul International Airport, after she was found with giraffe poop.
I can only imagine.
Well, imagine with a bucket. Okay. We got jizz pits for a year. The passenger stated that she obtained the droppings while on her trip and intended to make a necklace out of it. She told the officers she had previously used moose poop. To make jewelry at home. Oh yeah, I remember that woman. She was nasty.
Listen, it broke when I actually tried to buy one in wampum, and immediately I just couldn't get anything.
So we're gonna do with you in a minute. We're gonna wampum. But veterinary services permit is required if you want to bring feces into the United States.
You can actually bring back feces.
You can bring back feces, and you can, if it's...
For what fucking reason?
Apparently to make it to a jewelry.
Poop. Drink, by the way.
Don't you want a nice, you know...
Absolutely not.
Gorilla anus bracelet?
No.
No?
No.
No?
Welcome to the Home Shopping Network, where we have a gorilla anus bracelet for you today at the low, low price of
$29.99. Where did you get that tennis bracelet? Siberian tiger. Siberian tiger. That's made of Siberian tiger.
Yes,
kinda.
No.
What he ate is more like it. So technically, I guess it's monkey. Because I saw him eat a monkey. What?
And then it was Momo who actually
asked. Oh,
poor Momo.
By the way, this is number one, and this one's number two. Hell. Now, what else are they stopping? Carolina, this has something to do with one of your stories about 2 weeks ago.
A mummy.
No.
Oh.
1 week further. Baggage screening at Salt Lake City International Airport. What?
The chances of Carolina actually remembering this story from 3 weeks ago is very little.
I don't know the story. I just read it this episode.
Baggage screening in Salt Lake City, and if anybody can do a Utah accent, go ahead.
Nope.
Was halted for 2 hours after TSA officials found a suspicious item in a checked bag. They saw what appeared to be a skull. Do you remember the skull?
I was just going to flip
donated back. Donated at Goodwill.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Well, this was a skull, but it had components inside, according to the X-ray system. It resembled an explosive device.
Uh-oh.
Shit. Officers inspected the skull and discovered it was plastic, putty, and had a 9-volt battery and a sensor. After they spoke with the people who did it, it was determined it's actually used for medical training for surgeons to learn how to do a lobotomy.
Oh!
Where you drill into someone's skull.
Wait.
You can do it.
You can still do a lobotomy?
I don't know if you can, but apparently they're training people. And thank God on plastic.
Wow.
Although it was not an explosive device, TSA officers said, scary. That's not going on the plane. And it was held by TSA until it's picked up by a traveler when he returns to Salt Lake City.
By the elephant poop? Perfectly fine.
No, that was destroyed.
I don't understand why I can't go on the plane.
I don't know either, unless, you know, they think that they're lying and it can be an explosive device.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
I mean, aren't there trained professionals there that can tell if that's a bomb or not?
There's a fly in here I'd like to bomb, but
imagine if the Bob sniffing dog comes and is like,
it's a good question.
No.
And, you know, that's a good question. And I bet we get a couple of good questions out of this.
Carolina. Carolina.
What's in Carolina's corner?
Just the Amish Mafia.
Amish Mafia. All right. So this was a show that was back on. By the way, we're not talking about the same show, by the way. So,
we're not.
No, we're not. But Amish Mafia was a show that happened in 2012.
It's a show.
It's a show. It was on Discovery Channel.
But it's supposed
Channel.
To be realistic.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because the Mafia just wants you documenting their.
Well, it's supposed to be reportedly to be a Mafia in an Amish community. Like, they're the people that take care of all of the issues.
Hey, that Bonio's, it'd be a shame if it burned down, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Apparently.
So
I want some fritters. I want your wife's fritters.
Drink?
No.
Is it like the Amish Mafia?
What?
No. So it's not like the
no,
Mafia.
No, it's the Amish Mafia. There's an Amish guy who has a nicer house than everyone else, but it's still plain. He's still Amish.
Okay.
There's a lot of reports that this is a completely fake show that was an entirely fictional creation for entertainment purposes and was known as being bigoted toward and defaming the Amish people.
Because the Amish can't complain.
No, not at all.
They're not even watching, so
did
how would
you
they
see
know?
That show? No. Okay, then.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Well, Drake, they gave me a phone, and then I looked at it all of a sudden, and then they're like, what is this?
By the way, okay, wait.
Yes.
Now, let's run the simulation again. Now, the alert is to alert us in case something happens nationally.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If there is a national emergency...
Mm-hmm.
So picture it. They're in the big congregation hall, and they're talking about their lives and who's going to do what. And then all of a sudden, you hear like 12 phones go off and the whole thing, bam, 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 bam. And people are, you know, why do you have technology? But then the message says everyone get to higher ground. There's a tidal wave or whatever. Mm-hmm. And you save these people's lives. Are they going to come down on you?
Yes, because they probably believe that they could have gotten through this without technology. Like
or the Lord would have spared them or taken their lives, depending upon.
I don't think they would have listened to them.
Why do I have this talking box? And uh-huh. And by the way, why is the screen cracked?
7 years of bad luck for all of us.
You broke our soul, man. Oh, and because you broke our soul, I have to play this music.
Okay.
Go ahead.
So what if there is an emergency? The Amish people just die because they don't want to be...
Yes.
Oh.
Well, they believe in the Lord. That the Lord will save them.
What they do during COVID? I wonder if Amishing...
They were probably very Amish happy because there's nothing that they could have actually done.
But they can't sell their wares. Remember, everybody goes down to Intercourse, Pennsylvania.
Yes.
To buy, you know, oh, I'm going to get the butter and I'm going to get the farm stuff.
You can buy stuff from them?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. They make some great stuff.
I'm sure people went
out. Really?
You, a traveler, has never been to Intercourse, Pennsylvania?
No, why the fuck would I go to an Amish city? I just thought there was no lights.
Well, there isn't. No, it's a lot of fun. It really is.
I feel like, that would be something you would like, actually.
Intercourse, Pennsylvania.
Where are you trying to send me, Ira?
No, it's Intercourse, Pennsylvania. It's a real
place. Wait. Where am I trying to send
you? Fernando, we need to go to Intercourse tonight.
It's either Intercourse or Lancaster. You can go to, they're right next to each other, I believe.
Okay.
And no, it's a lot of fun. We used to bring Maya there because, you know.
That's cool. I would like to see how they live.
It's fun. And they sell a lot of stuff.
Just watch the Weird Al Yankovic video for Amish Paradise, and you'll know how that
you know.
Oh, please!
My manager was like, "I'm gonna buy a farm from the Amish," and I'm like,
"Yeah,
I don't know what she's talking about, but okay."
You can.
And now I know. All right then.
I mean, they still have real estate holdings. I'm like, oh, I'm gonna sell this one. I'm gonna buy that land, and I'm gonna give it to Jebediah. And his new wife.
Jizbit.
And they're going to raise 3 plain children and open up a barn. And there you go.
Wow.
And I'm Canadian again for some reason. Okay. Well, I know this part of the show. I throw it to Pickles and he says stuff.
I do. We're doing YouTube.com for our Circling the Drain page where we will put up shows that we have done. We will put up punishments that Carolina will eventually torture us with, and we will hate.
Oh, they're going to be good.
Miserably. I might call out like for the next 3 weeks. I'll be like, I can't do it. I can't. Oh, God. Now it's a real horror movie. But just go over there. We have a lot of good stuff. I guess I'll promote the TikTok too.
Since if somebody would put up new TikToks, we'd be really happy.
At CTD Podcast. listen, I will be putting up some new TikToks. I'll probably be cutting up this show and I'll be putting up segments from it. Thank you for all of those who clicked from the last one too.
There you go.
Life is hard. Listen, people, I try, but I understand with Pickles. It's hard. Listen,
did a good
it's
job.
Hard.
Don't worry.
But quick questions will be posted up, and you best believe that the punishments will be posted on Instagram because they're gonna be
good.
And
what's the page?
The page is Circling the Drain Podcast. So go check that out. There'll be some new stuff on there.
Okay,
soon.
Since you took TikTok and Instagram and YouTube, that just leads me go to anywhere and download our show. You can listen, like, rate, review, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Remember to go to Cake Chick Instagram. Her handle is CakeChick1217. And on Facebook, it's just Cake Chick. You go there, you use promo code CTD, you get 20% off. Give her at least a week. You know, just DM her and we'll discuss whatever you want to have your cake look like. Because of Cake Chick, you get what you want. Now, let's see. Also, Best of Long Island. If you remember or don't remember, Govs Radio has been nominated for Best Radio Studio. And a vote for them is like a vote for us. So you want to go over there and you want to vote for us.
Yay.
It's not an honor just to be nominated. We want to win.
We want to win. We
do. That'd be nice.
Maybe we'll get Momo the Monkey to come out here and
give us our special.
Or Maddie the Mattress.
Maddie the Mattress, Momo the Monkey, and Michael who's
Michael
serving
the Idiot.
Time.
He'll rob us.
He'll see serving time. Sean, feel better.
Yes.
He'll
better.
Be back next week, hopefully. And I guess I got nothing else to say, but if you give us a chance,
we'll give you a laugh.
That was terrible. If you give us a chance,
we'll give you a laugh.
And Carolina will not chop off your head.
I just might.
Oh, man.